guys.
I'm Daphne Quay, your Boss Lady Realtor. Today, I have got a full, nicely packaged video that we're going to unbox about Round Rock, Texas. Like I mentioned, today we're going to talk about Round Rock. We're going to talk about a couple really cool neighborhoods there. We're going to talk about why it's popular. We're going to go into a little bit of the history of it. And we're going to talk about the growth that Round Rock has seen in the last decade. I'm trying to give you a full scope of the magic town that is Round Rock.
In my opinion, Round Rock has always been kind of a more established suburb that people have really, really been drawn to. There's been a ton of reasons. Round Rock really started growing after they finished developing the Dell campus there in the late 90s. The Dell headquarters in Round Rock was really one of the first IT campuses to hit Austin. After that, then we saw Apple and then Samsung, right? And it was just a bunch of other ones started coming, but that was really one of the first ones. And for that reason, people wanted to live in Round Rock. There's a lot of things that were really appealing about Round Rock. At the time, when it started to really take off, it was very affordable. Round Rock is known for having highly rated schools. If you check out greatschools.org, you can check out the school ratings per neighborhood in Round Rock. Also, if they were in Round Rock, then the commute to the Dell campus was gonna be super short. So there were a lot of things that were really appealing about it. At the time, before we had a ton of traffic, the commute from Round Rock to downtown Austin was like 20 minutes. There just weren't as many people as there are today, of course, so it was a very quick commute. Over the last 10 years, Round Rock has been growing by leaps and bounds. When I first moved to Austin, my first apartment was actually in Round Rock, really close to the downtown area. And that was a really cute little spot to be, but there wasn't that much going on there. There are some historic buildings where there were offices and I think maybe a couple restaurants, and the Round Rock Library was there. But now there's so much more going on. So I had mentioned earlier, Round Rock is also famous for Round Rock Donuts, which is downtown, and they're awesome and super delicious and unique, and you really should go check it out. Also, because Austin's been growing so much and Pflugerville has been growing so much and everything has been growing, the downtown Round Rock scene has become kind of a little hotspot. There's a bunch of really cute little restaurants that are there. There are several rooftop bars and just like a lot of development around it. There's a little bar that hosts Latin night on Sunday nights called Rocky's Piano Bar, I think. And they move all the tables and they clear the floor and then they bring in a DJ and they play Latin music all night right in downtown Round Rock. And we just stay there dancing. Every time I go to Rocky's for salsa night, there's a bunch of other clubs playing like top 40s music. There's one spot that's consistently playing top hits from the early 2000s, which is so cool. There's just a lot of really cool things going on there. One spot that I really like in downtown Round Rock is this adorable little restaurant. It's called Urban Eat Drink. From what I could tell, it looks like a little house that was in downtown Round Rock that was just completely redone to be a restaurant. Indoors, it's kind of this old house feel to it with like the original wood floors and like the vaulted ceilings. You go outside, there's a huge outdoor patio. They have live music sometimes. Really good menu. Last time I was there with some girlfriends, there were a lot of us. We got just a ton of appetizers. So we got like the French fries and the Brussels sprouts. I think somebody ordered like chips and guac. So, I mean, it's not like super like foreign exotic food, but it's pretty good quality like Americana food. And they had really good drinks as well. The atmosphere was awesome. And the type of people that went there were super trendy. I mean, like really cool folks. It really felt like we were downtown Austin. And parking was pretty easy.
Please make sure to hit the subscribe button and to hit the like button so that I can continue making videos like this with lots of information for your brain.
As far as home prices go in Round Rock, it varies quite a bit. I looked at home sales history in Round Rock in the last 120 days. There were like over 1,000 homes that came up. So I narrowed down the search for homes that were 1,800 to 2,200 square feet, which is kind of like a good average size that I see there. Often prices I'm seeing range anywhere from $313,000 all the way up to $650,000. Now there is a lot of variety in the style of home that you can get in Round Rock. There are a lot of older homes there that were built, I would say like in the 60s and 70s, that are like ranch style homes on really spacious lots. Or if you like kind of a newer feel, there are a lot of newer communities that are further out in Round Rock that are like master planned communities that have amenities like walking trails, community pools, some of them have fitness areas. It just depends what you're looking for. But the newer ones tend to be further out in Round Rock. The older homes tend to be closer to like the downtown Round Rock area, closer to the highways, and have, in my opinion, better access to things that you would need just on like a day-to-day. But again, it depends what your priorities are and what you're looking for. Some of the big attractions that are really popular in Round Rock, one of the, like, the older ones, sort of, is the Dell Diamond, which is a baseball field that is owned by the Dell family, Dell Computers, of course. And that's just, that basically sits like right next to Old Settlers Park, which is a really cool park in Round Rock. I feel like it's highly underrated. There's walking trails there, there's a pond there. I mean, you can, there's just space to like run around, play some sports, like go hang out, take your dog for a walk. And then Dell Diamond is a baseball field, but they have a lot of sporting events. They have a lot of like community events in general. Another major attraction in Round Rock that's super new is the Kalahari Water Park, I believe, resort. And it is just that. It is a water park. It's enormous. I went a couple of months ago for actually a dance event, and I kind of got lost and I had to walk through like a lot of it to get to where I was going. And it was huge. It was never ending. I got to see the outdoor pool, the slides and the games and like the lazy pool that they have. And it's humongous. They also have a ton of nice restaurants inside. You can get like pizza Italian food. You can get like American style food. I think they have Mexican food as well. Like you can literally get whatever you want there. They also have an enormous arcade type setup there. It's like a separate building, but it's also kind of connected to the water park. It's basically like an adult Chuck E. Cheese with a roller coaster inside. It's insane. And it's like a cool getaway if you live in Round Rock, or like honestly, if you live in Austin, you just want to get away for a weekend and like unplug and like go hang out in the water, go play some games and just like have some fun. That is my take on Round Rock and all the growth that has been going on there and why it's such a great place to live and why so many people like living there. Round Rock is one of these towns in Austin that is constantly growing, so I could do a video on Round Rock this year and I'll probably do another one next year and it'll be like different because there's so much more development going on literally everywhere. Anyway, if you're thinking about buying a home or selling a home in Central Texas, please feel free to reach out. You can call me, email me, text me, send me an Instagram DM, whatever works for you. If you're thinking about making a move, I got you. Till next time.